give us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord. A word from the Lord.
To be a preacher.
Just one
to
word
today from
reading
you and let you know
we'll
that
move
even though you're going
down
through a drug
and cause a sun to shine. And give us peace.
Your grandchild addicted to crack. Oh, you think that somehow that because you came from a difficult past, because you came from a family with more issues than Vogue magazine, and God is saying that I still want to reach you like I've reached past the eton, and I want you to make meaning, true meaning out of your life. He wants to work all of that stuff together for good because he loves you and he's calling you according to his purpose. At this time, you've been set up by the sovereignty of God, and right now he wants to reach you. He wants you to stop having excuses because you think your life is messed up. Oh, I've been in some messed up places doing some messed up times, but I serve the Lord anyhow, like Job had to serve the Lord anyhow. Let me speak to Job right now. You love the Lord. You've been giving everything to the Lord. And it seemed like that this whole crisis, this mortgage crisis, this crisis in the stock market has taken everything away from you. And you're wondering whether God still loves you, whether God still cares for you. And God is saying right now, you've been set up by the sovereignty of God. He knows what you lost, but you didn't lose your relationship with God, and you have to be like Job. And this is my favorite saying, and have to say hallelujah anyhow. Oh, that's what Job said when he lost all his children. That's what Job said when he lost everything in his stock market. He said, naked I came into this world, and naked I shall return. Blessed, I say, blessed be the name of the Lord. And you, Job, you've got to say right now, even though I've lost everything, oh, my wife's talking to me crazy, I've lost my children, oh, you've got to say hallelujah anyhow, hallelujah anyhow, because of the sovereignty of God is reaching to you right now. And God wants to encourage you. Oh, Job, continue to serve the Lord because he loves you. And he sent me over these television air to let you know personally in your own home, a personal delivery of God's message that he loves you and for you to not give up in Jesus' name. You've been set up by the sovereignty of God. And this plot that you can't understand, God is saying, when you can't understand, like the song says, you need to trust his heart. For the Bible says, trust in the Lord with all your heart, and to lean not to your own understanding, but in all of your ways, acknowledge him right now, and he will make your path straight. God loves you, and the sovereignty of God is reaching you right now. God loves you. And I'm running out of time. And I want to take this opportunity and give this message from God for those who do not have a personal relationship with God. That's what Christmas is all about. You see, I don't have anything against Santa Claus and Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. I love the beautiful colors that you're putting out, or you have put out here in Paul's Valley. I probably was at the parade and saw the floats. But you know what? That's not what Christmas is really all about. It's wonderful and it's nice. But Christmas is all about you. Oh, man and woman who do not know the Lord, it's about you. God wants to get to know you in a personal way. And all you have to do right now If you want God to be with you, all you have to do right now is to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You can pray this simple prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, I confess you right now, and I ask you to forgive me of my sins. Wash and cleanse me with the blood of Jesus. For I believe that Jesus is God's Son, that he died for my sins, was buried, and rose again on the third day. Dear Jesus, come into my heart.
Another calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.